What is up, guys? It is Wednesday.
It is Wednesday, my dudes.
12:44. I'm heading to the gym. Look at where we are. Gonna try to burn some fat.
Can I have my chili Fritos?
Can't have shit. I'm closed, fat boy.
Now, there's a post on my Facebook yesterday. It was a memory. It was a memory 4 years ago when I was training for MMA. I never had a fight. Never got to my first fight. But I trained for 2 years, really strict. I was just involved 100% in it, traveling all around the Midwest, Cedar Rapids, all the way to Illinois, going to different MMA gyms, just learning different techniques, different strategies, different workouts, different coaching, basically. Because that's what, if you want to be a truly good martial artist, you kind of want to go around that first in the beginning to try to find a gym that you believe would be good for you and that you can learn and feel comfortable in. Now, back then, I was around 150 pounds. I was always going back and forth from like 146 to 157, always depended on what I was eating, what kind of workouts I was doing. But I always remembered how slim I was, how much of great energy I had every single day, and just the amount of energy that I put out throughout the day. I'd train for 2 to 3 hours straight. I'd be hydrating with some water or some Gatorade or whatnot, but it was a 2-3 hour workout. I'd do a warm up for 3 miles on the treadmill, a nice steady jog at around 7.0. I'll do that for about three miles nonstop, get my heart rate going, get my blood pumping. It usually take about 22 to 24 minutes to complete the 3 miles on the treadmill. I'd speed up maybe at the end around 7.5 to 8.0. It felt so good. And then after that 3 mile jog, then I'd stretch a little bit, do some torso twists, do some side bends, do a little bit of jump rope. I'd do about 100 jump ropes. And then I'd go to my sparring workouts. I'd hit the heavy bag for about the 5 rounds that we were always being trained for. 5 minute, 5 rounds. Practice my techniques, practice my power, practice my precision, keep spotting a spot on the heavy bag where it's kind of my head level. I'm 5'8", so around 5'8", just straight. Now just try to focus on that one little circle that you just put as a target, basically. And just practice your technique, practice hitting that precisely over and over and over. Some leg kicks, body kicks, body shots. So I saw that post yesterday and I was like, you know what? I want to try to do that because I burned so much fat during that time when I was trying to get to 145 for featherweight. Those are my workouts I'd do and I'd feel so great. I'd feel unstoppable. I'd have so much energy. I'd be like 6% body fat. My punches were fast. My kicks were swift. And seeing that post yesterday on my Facebook, I was like, you know what? Yeah, I'm running. I'm doing some cardio workouts, maybe some HIIT workouts here and there. But I lost a lot of weight and got in really great shape by doing MMA training. You know what? I thought, hey, I got a little fat to lose still. I'm not where I want to be. So let's do a challenge. Let's try to do this workout. So I'm going to go to the gym today. But I woke up in the mood of just doing this little challenge by seeing that post yesterday. So I'm going to try it today. I woke up, I started my old routine. I used to have a strict routine every single day, every single week, working out for MMA. Woke up, immediately had some of my Fiji water, fasted a little bit. I waited about an hour till I ate breakfast. Then I had a little bit of oatmeal, some chia seeds, a little bit of raisins, a little bit of blueberries for some sugar and antioxidants. Added some cinnamon, and I cooked a little bit of egg whites for some extra protein. That was my breakfast. And while I'm waiting for another hour to eat, I'm drinking water, I'm hydrating. Before all of my workouts, I always drink enough water to where my pee is almost clear. If it's light yellow, if it's barely visible for a color, that's where you want to be before you work out. If you're peeing and it's dark, that means you're not totally hydrated yet. Trust me, you'll have a better performance when you're super hydrated. It's always worked for me. It's never done me wrong. I've always had 2 to 3 hour workouts. I feel great when I'm hydrated. I'll have my BCAAs with some water. I'll have some greens mixed with some water, depending on the day. Right around my second small meal, I'll have some almonds for a snack with a little bit of cottage cheese. And then right before I go to work out, probably an hour before I work out, I have some rice and cottage cheese. Today I had brown rice, heated that up, put a little bit of cottage cheese with it. I make sure I have enough water. I make sure I do my pee test. Make sure I'm hydrated. And then I take my pre-workout, just like the stack that I showed you in one of my earlier videos. And I always take my pre-workout half an hour after I eat. If you wait half an hour after you eat, that pre-workout's gonna go straight to your body. It's gonna go, it's gonna get digested super quick because there's no food in the way. And I only put it with around, I used to put around 8 ounces of water, but I learned that if you put it in less water, say around 2 to 4 ounces of water, you get a bit more feeling because the water is diluting it a little bit. I'm not that guy who puts the, who gets the powder and scoops and just puts it in my mouth. It always makes me cough. I hate it. And then you sip it down with some water. That's just not me. I at least put it with 2 to 3 ounces of water just so I can down it like a shot. And then I'll still feel the pre-workout. And then I wait about 15 minutes. I watched a motivational video 4 or 5 years ago. The notorious Conor McGregor was coming up in the rankings in UFC. I always watched his videos and his sparring routines and his workouts. It always inspired me. So when I went to the gym, I kind of had my envision. See? He even have his hat.
Bruh.
Wearing his hat kind of makes me feel powerful a little bit. It's kind of like an emblem back then when I was training for MMA. I always wore this, always gave me a little bit of power. Just because of what Conor represents and the man that he is and became today. So I'm almost at the gym. I'm getting ready. I'm going to do a 3 mile jog for a warm up. I'm going to try 6.5 at the beginning, but if it's easy, I'm going to knock it up to 7.0. Try to do it nonstop. I'm going to see if I can do this. And then after that, I'm gonna stretch a little bit. Might do some body workouts like some pull-ups and some push-ups, some dips, some air squats, working all parts of the body. Then I'm gonna do my jump rope session, and then I'm gonna grab my gloves and hit the bag for a little sparring routine. I love doing it because it even works your core, it works your whole body. MMA workouts are just phenomenal. Even wrestling workouts, like the workouts that like WWE superstars do, they're doing movement training, they're doing wrestling, they're doing grappling, they're moving their body, falling to the ground, standing back up. So that's why MMA train, I'm going back to it just for a little while, just to burn some quick fat. It's one of the best workout routines to do to burn fat. It's something different than always running on the treadmill, always biking, always doing just this, on a stationary machine, just doing it for 15 to 30 minutes. This is something different. It's going to work out your whole body. It's going to be, it's pretty much like a HIIT workout, but you're incorporating strikes, you're moving your core, you're twisting your body, using your shoulders, using your feet. I'm excited, I'm pumped for it. If you guys need help on the workout routine that I did or any of my diet plans that I did, I'll leave them in the comments below. I'll leave whatever I ate, whatever brand I ate, and I'll show you some clips of the workout.
My brother when he spoke to me, and I never would have played with my conscience in the fields where I walked in the company, but you gave me wings and I used them blinding and my heart weighs down. I think I'll get a job of seeing people stunder. Folks back home, I will make them proud. You gave me wings and I used them. I used them. I used them on my youth. Yeah, you gave me wings and I used them. I used them. I don't wanna lose them. I don't wanna lose them. I don't feel my dreams when I'm in my city.
About an hour into my workout now. I'm exhausted. I'm gonna keep on pushing, got half an hour to go.
Guys, I got through it. Wow. That was hard. I'm surprised I could keep up. Even though I have 25 extra pounds from when I used to do those workouts. Yeah, I was slower, I was tighter. Lost a lot of breath and had to take breaks. But working towards progression. Whew. After those workouts, I'd usually hit the wet sauna for about 10 to 15 minutes. I'd be exhausted, but going in that 120 degree temperature room with all the moisture to the point where you could almost not see the person next to you. That was getting all the water out. I mean, the saunas in general, just, they're great for your health. They're good for longevity. They're good for inflammation in the body. Good for opening up your lungs, getting all that sweat out of your pores. The heat does incredible things to your body. Releases heat shock proteins. One day I really want to try a cryotherapy. I haven't tried a cryotherapy yet. If any of you tried one, please tell me about it. I've seen a lot of MMA fighters, pro athletes. One big example is Brian Shaw, or The Undertaker. He recently did a cryotherapy session, and it's supposed to just recover your body like almost instantly. Like it goes like 200, like negative 200-300, I'm not really sure, degrees, and your head's sticking out, but your whole body's just, it's getting frozen. It gets so cold that your body thinks it's dying, so its natural instinct is to rush all the blood, surface of your skin, I believe. I'm not 100% sure, I haven't tried it yet. I haven't talked to anybody about it yet. I gotta look it up on YouTube sometime, but it's really good for recovery. It's pretty much like an ice bath, but it takes 2 minutes, 3 minutes. It's around 65 to 70 bucks. There's a cryotherapy chamber place, I believe, on the other side of town, on the northeast side of Cedar Rapids, Iowa. I'll have to try it out sometime. I've tried isolation tanks in Des Moines, but I haven't tried a cryotherapy yet, but it'd just be nice just to feel that recovery. I never done an ice bath. I've never done a cryotherapy. Surprised with those workouts I used to do. I would have been even better if I would have done some kind of ice recovery therapy. Getting into bodybuilding, you know, it's a lot of cardio, a lot of weightlifting. It's a lot of stress on your body, mentally and physically, because you're working out so much a week. You're dieting. Your body's going through changes. Of course, I haven't done a serious regimen for like a good year or so. So my body's going like, whoa, what's this new change? What's this? What are you doing? You're working out really hard and you're doing all these weights. We have to build our muscles more, but then you do cardio, you're tricking the body. It's a lot of stress under the body, and that's why recovery and sleep is very important. Nutrition is very important. Recovery time is very important. I work out every other day. I've been doing that for a long time. For me, it helps the best. Especially when you're younger, you can do more. Especially if even the second day, you'd be fully recovered, you'd be ready to go. Your battery would be fully charged. But the older you get, just like an older battery, the older the battery gets, the less lifespan it's gonna have, and it's gonna take even longer to recover. maxing out your body every single day, especially if you do it 7 days a week, your battery's probably really low. It's going to be struggling, and if you're trying to get the most output, it's going to use a lot of that power quick. You're going to be exhausted fast. So what I like to do at almost 30 years old now, I like to do every other day. I do a hard 2 hour session, an hour and a half if I'm, depending on how I'm feeling. Push it really hard, work on all the parts that I need to. And then I go home, eat good nutrition, eat in a 12 hour frame, go to bed at around 10, wake up at 6, sometimes 7, just to get that little extra sleep. 9 hours isn't bad. And I just take a rest day. I eat good. I rest a little bit, but I still go walking. I still, just standing up and walking to the kitchen, it's cardio. Cardio is just moving your body. Lost my train of thought. I'm exhausted from that workout. Whew. Haven't done that for a long time, but it feels great. Got a little runner's high, I believe, or just a workout high. Gonna go home now, have my vegan shake, a little bit of rice milk in Fiji. Gonna cook some chicken tonight. I already got some brown rice cooked, got some white rice in the fridge. Gonna have that first supper tonight. A little teriyaki sauce. Seasonings don't hurt, especially if you eat right. Whew, but yeah, that was great. But I'm feeling progress, I'm seeing progress. I lost 4 pounds so far, which in bodybuilding, you know, it doesn't really matter how much weight. It depends what kind of weight, what kind of weight class you want to go for. But really, it's not about the weight on the scale. It's just about, it's really about your body composition, your body fat percentage, and sometimes it's how your clothes feel. A good predictor if you're losing weight, especially trying to burn fat, is how your clothes fit on you. If you're burning calories and you're burning fat, you don't necessarily have to go on the scale all the time. A scale, yes. If you're super overweight or to the point of obesity, yes, it's going to be crucial to lose a lot of weight. That's when the scale is going to come in handy. But if you're just a little, if you're just a little overweight, if you're just in the overweight category of the BMI, if the scale isn't changing much and you're getting frustrated about the progression that you're trying to lose, like, oh, I'm trying to burn fat but I'm not losing weight, the best thing to do is just kind of see how your clothes fit. Take measurements of your waist to your hip, waist and hip ratio. Take measurements of your arms, your neck, your legs. Take measurements of everything around you, because yeah, it can be frustrating that your body won't be losing pounds so much, especially if you're doing weightlifting while you're trying to burn fat. You're going to be keeping around the same weight, but gaining muscle is going to keep you from not losing that weight, but you might be losing fat. If I was you, I'd take measurements. Just a few tips for you guys out there. I know some people get frustrated when they're trying to lose weight. They're working out for a good month, and they're like, oh, I only lost 2 or 3 pounds. It's so frustrating. I want to lose 30 pounds, but it's just taking forever. It takes a while to burn fat. Fat is easy to gain, super hard to lose. It's annoying how the human body works sometimes. But it's just all diet, workout. It's simple, keep it simple. But just doing measurements of your body, just seeing how your clothes fit. If you're wearing a large and you're like, oh my God, this large is getting kind of big on me now, that means you're burning fat. Thanks for watching, guys. If you want to hear and see more of my journey to a better body, subscribe to my YouTube channel. I'll be posting thoughts, workouts, result pictures, meal ideas, so much content I'll be sharing with you. Until next time, Kai out.